Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. Oh my gosh, it has been so long since I filmed. It's just been so busy. I kind of told you guys a few videos back that my mom was here and work and things like that. And then I got this hideous cough and I lost my voice last weekend, if you guys follow me on Instagram. So I couldn't really talk anyway. And I've just been dying to film a Will I Buy It video. So it's Friday night. I got home from work and I decided that my makeup still looked presentable enough to put on YouTube. And I wanted to film a Will I Buy It video because there are so many new makeup launches I want to talk to you guys about. And yeah, it's just been an exciting March. I feel like March really blew up in the most unexpected way. And we have a lot to talk about. I'm just gonna scooch over to the side and get started. You guys know I like to use Trend Mood, and then some of the indie brands I'm going to talk about, I'm gonna be referencing their actual Instagrams. So I will, you know, try and mention each reference when I'm on to that. So today there were so many announcements for Fenty. Fenty's coming out with a bunch of new stuff. They're doing a bunch of kilowatt highlighters as well as a bronzer collection. I'm so excited because I feel like I predicted bronzers and like I put it out to the universe that I wanted brands to get more serious about bronzers because I feel like bronzers are so underrated. I love wearing bronzers and I have a very hard time finding ones that work with my skin tone. A lot of the mainstream bronzers that people discuss, like Hoola and MAC and Me Sun, they don't all work on my skin tone, especially if you're darker than me. I feel like there's not a lot of good options out there. I, for the longest time, would repurchase Casino by NARS because that was really the only one that I felt like worked with my skin tone. So I'm so excited that a brand like Fenty is doing bronzer because it looks like they're gonna come out with so many different shades and, you know, there's gonna be a little bit for everyone. So I'm very, very excited for that collection and it's launching on April 5th. So I don't even have to wait too long. I believe that's next Friday. So yeah, I'm so excited for them to do bronzers as well as new little bronzer duos. They're doing some new kilowatt foil like highlighters. There's a red one coming out and yeah, there's just so many cool things that they announced today. So let me scroll down here. They're doing like some more split band kilowatts. One's called Afternoon Shack and Mo Honey. And oh my gosh, I'm just so, so excited for that. So I will definitely be picking that up and look for a review on my channel because if it works for me, I want to tell you guys about it in case you're my skin tone so you can go ahead and purchase as well. Okay, so this one was tough for me because I really dislike the Melt Stax formula, but I have purchased one in the past. That's how I know I don't like it. And I actually sold that on Poshmark like probably like a year or two ago. But I do have the Melt Smoke Sessions palette. And honestly, that's like one of my all-time favorite palettes. I love greens. I love the formula. Melt has an issue with their formula. You know, people swear by them up and down, and that's great for them. But in my personal opinion, I feel like their formula is very hit or miss. I was lucky with my Smoke Sessions palette because it's still intact, but I've heard many, many people say on their YouTube channel they're scared if they drop it because they know it'll go into a million pieces. I feel the same way. I have to handle that with special care. I will never travel with that palette, and a lot of the pans in that palette are actually overfilled, so the formula is like puffing out. I think I saw on Instagram that somebody's maybe was getting mold in it. I'm not 100% sure, but it's just so hit or miss, so it's very hard to recommend the brand. They just launched today this new stack called the Shapeshift Stack, which includes four shades for $48. And the one shade in this palette that's really calling to me is that blue shade. But I basically had this in my cart. I was gonna buy it, and then I was like, Karen, like, you don't need to keep doing this to yourself. You literally have colors like this, plus you don't even know how the formula is gonna be. The blue shade that I love reminds me so much of that blue shade in the Pat McGrath palette, the blue palette that she came out with over the holidays, and I don't even use that palette enough, so I decided to talk myself down from it. It is $48, and there's four shades, and it's beautiful. It's really, really beautiful, but I will never, ever, ever get through a whole stack of Melt shadows, and just because of how inconsistent the formula is, I decided to skip it. But yeah, that was really, really beautiful. And then today, of course, the 29th, was the launch of the Jeffree Star Blue Blood Collection. I know so many people that were so, so excited to get their hands on this palette, and I don't blame them. I was definitely one of them. He's got a huge collection. He had the palettes, the liquid lips, the skin frost, or whatever they're called, the liquid skin frost. He had, you know, merch. He had the lip scrubs and all this cool stuff. I wanted to maybe get something else, but realistically, I know, like, I have one lip scrub and I'm nowhere near even close to making a dent in it, so I didn't want to pick any of that other stuff up. And I tried to get it on Jeffree's website because I felt like it was gonna ship faster, but I'm sure some of you were trying to shop as well and his website kept crashing, probably from all the traffic. But I actually managed to snag it on Beautylish, which worked out perfectly for me because then I was able to do like a payment plan, and I picked up this Sonia G brush I've been dying to try, as well as those oils. What are they called? They're a new brand that Beautylish is carrying. What are they called? Good Molecules. There's like a whole little set where you can spend $56 and get the whole collection. So I did that, and I'm really excited for some good skincare. So yeah, I'm just so excited for the Blue Blood palette because I loved the Blood Sugar palette. I've tried a lot of Jeffree Star eyeshadow palettes. I bought Beauty Killer back in the day and I just did not like it. So I sold that to a friend, and then I never bought Androgyny. I didn't like Thirsty at all. I didn't like that formula, so I definitely returned that. And I have Blood Sugar, which really, really sucked me in. Formula is amazing. I have the Alien palette. I must say, I haven't played with the Alien palette enough. I'm so bad, you guys, because I'm one of those people that, like, I have a full-time job, which I know is not an excuse, but it's hard for me to film after work usually. And I know a lot of YouTubers, it's like their full-time job to be on YouTube, and unfortunately I know I miss out on a lot of content that I want to create. Like, I buy things with really good intentions, but sometimes I just never come around to it. Anyway, I'm still really excited for the Blue Blood palette. I just watched Annette's video. She did like a first impression on it, and the look she created was gorgeous. So I'm excited to get mine. I think they said it's gonna ship on Tuesday, April 2nd. So fingers crossed that that comes swiftly my way. And then today they also announced the Urban Decay and Game of Thrones collab. Well, they revealed the product, so that's going to be a huge collection for Urban Decay. They're doing an eyeshadow palette, a highlighter palette. They're doing four eyeliners, four lip shades, and then two brushes. The brushes, I'm sure, are lovely. I've used Urban Decay's brushes before, and they're nice. I won't be buying those. Not really interested in, you know, traditional lipsticks. It's not really my favorite formula, so I won't be buying any of those. The eyeliners do look beautiful. The swatches, I don't love the swatches that Urban Decay are showing, but the do dark shades look beautiful. They have like a duochrome heavy glitter look to them, so kind of curious about that. Not interested in the highlighting palette. Those shades look so basic. I wish they had thrown in like some kind of colorful, like a something dragon-y. Like, I feel like they could have done a little bit of a better job. The eyeshadow palette, again, it's not really like revolutionary shades. I feel like if an indie brand did a Game of Thrones palette, they would kill it. And this is like Urban Decay's mass marketed version of a Game of Thrones palette. So I'm a little bit disappointed. I'm like 20% curious to buy it just to like own it, But I'm also not like the biggest Game of Thrones fan. Like, it's a good show. I think if I had easier access to it, I would watch it. But since it's not on like Netflix or Hulu or Prime, and we would either have to buy cable or buy the seasons, I just don't have access to watching it. So I've only seen very, very little of Game of Thrones. So that's my whole Game of Thrones spiel. I feel like they could have done a better job, but okay, let me see the prices because I didn't see the prices. How much is the palette? Okay, so the Game of Thrones eyeshadow palette is $65. That's insane. That's really expensive. That's like a Huda palette. And then the eye pencils are $22 each. So that launches on April 14th, which I think is a Sunday. So I'm not sure about that. It's actually my dad's birthday on April 14th. So I thought that was a really interesting thing. But yeah. So yeah, what do you guys think of that particular collection? Definitely let me know down below. I made a whole video about the Ulta 21 Days of Beauty. So if you wanna know if there's anything I think that you should spend your money on, I will link it up in the cards so you guys can watch that. So Drunk Elephant came out with a makeup melting butter with kiwi, strawberry seeds, and virgin marula oil. And they also came out with a bamboo booster exfoliant physique. Actually, it says it'll be available tomorrow. I think I saw some influencers get it. I like the idea of a cleansing balm, but it's not like my favorite thing in the whole wide world. I prefer to use a makeup wipe. I know it's not the best thing for the environment, but to me, it's like when I need to put, like, I don't like to keep my balms in the shower, and then you have to make sure your hands are dry. So either you do the whole like taking off your makeup thing before you get in the shower. So I have the pharmacy makeup removing melt thing, and I like that, but I tend to not use it as much because I feel like it's such a hassle. I like to just wash my face in the shower, so I don't want to make like extra steps, you know what I mean? So that's all. But yeah, I'm sure people will really enjoy it. It's just not for me. Okay, so this was funny. We talked about this on my Instagram. Tarte did actually launch the Icy Betch palette. They did tweak it a little bit. Everyone said it's the same shades as the original one they showed as their April Fool's joke last year. But now they're actually releasing it, and it's going to be $24. It reminds me a lot of that new palette they just came out with called the High Tides and Good Vibes. I have a swatch party video. I will try and remember to link it up in the cards for you guys. But I don't know. I wish they had just done the palette that they showed. I wish they had just done it sooner. Like, they slept on this for so long. It, like, doesn't even make sense to me. I feel like it would almost have been better for them to just bury it and not do the Icy Betch palette, because I think it just drudge up a lot of like how dumb of a brand Tarte is. So yeah, I don't know. I feel like you don't really need that. So that's my opinion on that. I'm sure there's a lot of ColourPop to cover in this video, but they just launched this. They did new magnetic palettes, and they're so freaking cute. I literally just want to buy one so I can have that magnetic palette. I'm not going to because I don't need to. And I love that purple blush shade they're showing in this picture that I'll insert for you guys. It looks so beautiful. I love like a good fresh face blush. Oh my gosh. So I might pick that up in a ColourPop order in the future. I just don't want to place an order. I just for the sake of placing it, because I actually quite recently ordered this palette from them because I'd wanted a ColourPop blush palette for the longest time, and they were doing build your own palette, so I bought it then. So now I'm like, okay, I can't justify buying another one right away, so I'm going to be good. Okay, so another big launch this week were the new Pat McGrath single eyeshadows. She came out with 17 shades, and they're $25 each. I am in a little Instagram group with a bunch of people that love Pat McGrath as much as I do, and I know some of those ladies did pick up some of the singles. I personally am just not tempted by singles. I tend to use them so much less that I just didn't want to add them to my collection, plus they're not really affordable. I love her palettes. I'm actually wearing my Pat McGrath eyeshadows today just because I miss them, and so I put them on. And I love my palettes, but I just can't I just don't see the point. And from what I understood from my friends talking, only 6 of the shades are actually new shades. The rest of the shades are from previous palettes. So I think this is a great way for you to try Pat McGrath, but it's really not because of how expensive it might end up being. I would definitely recommend a palette, or she just came out with like a little set that has a little eyeshadow palette in it and a travel size mascara and a pigment, and that's $48 at Sephora. So I would recommend picking that up if you've wanted to try Pat McGrath. I feel like that's a better idea. Okay, here's another palette. I was so excited when they announced this. BH Cosmetics did their second collab with It's My Ray Ray, and they did another palette. And this one is really an interesting palette because she did like a matte and then two corresponding shimmer shades. So it's like a very monochromatic kind of palette. I don't think this is like life-changing by any means, but I just thought it would be a fun palette to play around with. I've really been enjoying BH Cosmetics lately, so I'm very, very excited to receive that in the mail and playing with it. And it also came out at Ulta, so if you don't want to shop on BH because they have unbelievably slow shipping, well, so does Ulta, so I guess that's a moot point, but at least you could use your points or something. I wish I'd known it was coming out at Ulta, but oh well. Either way, excited for that collection. Olimar Cosmetics just launched some new products. I was actually really excited for this. They did some blush trios, $22 each. And they also did some glosses that are $10 each. The thing I really like about the blush trios is they did 3 different options for 3 different skin tones. And I think that's so admirable, even for a brand, an indie brand like Olimar, to do different skin tones. Giving people options, I think, is so important. It always shocks me when brands come up with stuff and it's really clearly just for one skin type. So it makes me really happy to see a brand like Olimar embracing different skin tones. So I really hope that collection does well. I personally won't be buying anything from it, but I think it's really cool that they took different skin tones into consideration. So MAC is launching a MAC Electric Wonder collection with beautiful marble and pink gold details. This packaging is killer. You know, MAC's never done a bad job with their packaging, but when it comes to qualities, there's definitely a lot left to be desired. So they're doing some bronzing powders, some highlighters, some lipsticks, and then there's these big palettes. They're face palettes, so that's interesting. Oh, actually, they're doing a face palette, then they're doing some face brushes as well, and an eyeshadow palette. I don't really know too much about this whole situation. It says it's coming soon to the US, so not sure when it'll launch or if it'll be even available. Obviously, MAC is a huge global brand, so we don't really know much about when it's coming to the US, but you know, keep an eye out for it if you're wanting it. I personally will be passing on that. Okay, so Patrick Ta, you know, did announce that he was coming out with a new makeup line, and it looks like that's going to be available April 4th. They're doing some body oils as well as some highlighting mist and some setting, a major glow setting fan, I don't know what that is, a body brush and a lip shine. So, you know, I don't understand how many brands are gonna keep trying to sell us body glows. I feel like it's a little bit overrated. I know Fenty just came out with some too. I honestly wish brands would just stop. I mean, Sally Hansen has been making glowy products for your body for years, so I just feel like, you know what, just save yourself all of that money and just go to Walmart, okay? So NARS is doing a orgasm collection. I think we knew this was coming. I did see the Orgasm Blush Jumbo for $40 on Sephora already. I used to have Orgasm Blush. It was like one of the first high-end makeup products I purchased from Sephora. And trust me, I wore that thing. I hit pan. It was a whole thing, but I could never bring myself to repurchase that thing. So it's interesting. And there's a beautiful face palette as well. I don't really know a whole lot about this, but it looks really cool. I don't know. I have a love-hate relationship with NARS. Some of their face palettes work so well for me. Some of them are so shitty. So we'll have to see what the reviews are like. I definitely won't be running out and buying this. So it's a beautiful collection. It's a beautiful idea, but it's a pass for me. And then the Bomb came out with some new palettes. I thought these were interesting. They're called the Auto Bomb Collection, and it has like a license plate theme to it. It's a really cute idea, but honestly, I can't tell you the last time I was interested in anything from the Bomb. I think the only things I bought from them were like the Luminizers, because those were so hyped on YouTube forever ago, but I don't know. I don't know what's gonna like rescue the Bomb or revive their brand, or like, you know, who's still buying the Bomb. I don't really know. Don't get offended if you do. That's totally fine. I think they're a great brand. I just don't like their formula. Their shadows are very dry to me, and I don't know. There's just nothing unique about them. I mean, and their packaging just doesn't appeal to me. I know a lot of people love their packaging. It's just not my vibe. So, Nikita Dragon's Dragon Beauty products did launch, and she did a skin perfecting color correcting concealer and a transformation face powder. And then you could also get a kit which included the egg for like $105. So, I kind of loved how Angelica talked about this collection, as she was kind of trying to cater to their transgender community. And, you know, I can't even begin to like understand the makeup needs of somebody that is going through something like that. I have no idea. I can only talk about my skin and, you know, my experiences with the skin that I have. So I don't really know what the needs of the transgender community are. So I think that's cool that she did that. The only thing that I was kind of turned off by was like the presentation of it. How she had like, she was like showing up to like influencers' houses, and they were all putting it on Instagram, and she was like driving a Lamborghini, and she had like a model, which obviously I'm guessing was like a paid Ford model to like drive around in the car with her. And I just found the whole thing sort of tacky. I don't know. I just feel like I always think about like what like kids think when they see stuff like that. Like, it's like, oh my gosh, that's so cool. Like, no, it's not cool actually. It's just kind of cheesy and, you know, a little tacky. So, and she was wearing like these pants, but they were like, she was wearing like, they were like crotchless pants. It was a whole thing. So yeah, if you can look it up, definitely feel free to do that. MAC is coming out with new colorful extra dimension eyeshadows, and this is launching on April 11th. I never got into, again, the MAC extra dimension shadows. I can't do single shadows, so I won't be buying any of that. I know there's some people that love their extra dimension shadows, and you know, that's great for them, but just not my vibes. And then Too Faced launched their spring collection. It's called the Natural Lust Collection. Looks like the Natural Dust Collection. Yeah, I don't know. I don't know who's keeping Too Faced in business, you guys, but good for them. You know, they're really doing some things in this world. Zoeva came out with a beautiful collection called the Melody Collection. I honestly, guys, I bought like a vault of like Zoeva products, and I never even like was interested enough to like test them. I tried like one or two of the palettes, and I didn't really love their formula. I know they're really big in Europe. You can't buy Zoeva in the US. You have to buy on their website from Europe, and then it ships from Europe. So I wouldn't encourage any of you guys to like run out and spend your hard-earned money on Zoeva. I know it's tempting because they do beautiful things, but I just didn't think it was that great. So yeah, I would pass on it, to be honest. But I just want to share my opinion with you guys. If I can help anyone save some money, that's my main goal with my channel. Okay guys, so it's been so long since I filmed one of these that the NARS villain, that the ColourPop Villains collection was announced and launched, and I didn't really get to talk too much about it. So ColourPop launched a huge collab with Disney again, and they did Disney Villains this time, and they did the most. They did highlighters, glosses, lipsticks, an eyeshadow palette, and some glitter thingies, and some Jelly Mud shadows as well. And so they were all, you know, so fun. There were so many YouTubers that were dying to get their hands on these products, and they also launched them at Ulta, which I thought was a really smart move on their part. And I ended up picking up the eyeshadow palette just because it looked like a fun palette. I have seen people comparing it to the ColourPop x Shayla palette. I just got mine in the mail, so I don't really see the like comparison, but I probably need to pull out my Shayla palette and look. I wasn't really tempted by anything else in the collections. There were some beautiful things, but it was just like okay for me. So luckily I wasn't too affected by the whole thing, but I know a lot of people were really, really interested in that whole situation. Certify's new palette is now available for pre-order. I don't know how they ended up on Trend Mood, honestly, but I think Trend Mood's been really interested in that brand because of the unique color combinations that they present. So it's called the Affinity 2 Eyeshadow Palette, and it's $42, 18 shades, and it's cruelty-free. This palette does look beautiful. I feel like I have a lot of these green shades, and I have one of their palettes, and I still haven't used it. So even though I'm like slightly tempted to buy this, I keep telling myself like, don't buy it, first of all, because you have to ship it internationally. And their shipping is not that expensive, but it still ends up costing you about $50 for the whole thing. You already have a palette that you haven't tried from them. And yeah, those are the two main reasons. So I'm gonna try and be strong and just not pick it up. But I believe they have a code till April 1 for Mother's Day. If I remember, I'll put it like while I'm editing it so you guys can take advantage. And that gives you 25% off the palette. So kind of a steal. There's another palette that they came out with in the black packaging. I'll try and remember to put a picture in the corner so you guys know what I'm talking about. But that one sold out on their website. So I'm kind of bummed because I feel like if they had the black packaging one and this one together, I would totally pick it up. But now I'm just like kind of not really wanting to pay shipping for two palettes. Two separate times, so what I'm thinking of doing is just skipping the whole thing. I did buy this palette as well. This is the Bright and Colorful Color Festival palette by BH Cosmetics. They did a palette and some eye brushes, and these neon handles totally suckered me in. So I did pick up both of these items, and I'm excited to play with them when they come in. So yeah, excited. I think BH Cosmetics has done the most this couple of months so far into 2019. And yeah, I'm excited to see what else they come out with this year. So Stila Cosmetics did launch two new eyeshadow palettes, totally giving me Pat McGrath vibes. I can't believe this is Stila, honestly. I'm a little bit shocked. These are $52 each and limited edition. I haven't seen anyone talk about these on YouTube yet. Probably not anyone like I watch, but I'm interested to see what people think about these. I don't know if I'll go ahead and purchase them. Maybe if I see them in person and they look really beautiful, but nothing I'm like running for. But I was kind of like, oh, side eye for Stila for once, which literally never happens. I love some of the like the olive shades in this palette, but it's really not anything that drew me in. I believe Spooky Lips and Fat Hips bought this palette, so I'm waiting on her review for that. And then BH Cosmetics also did launch the new Zodiac palette. This is the Aries palette. I actually bought the, I don't know, I think I showed these in my March haul, which you guys might be seeing soon. But I actually bought, oh, I'm holding a Colored Rain palette. Just so you know, the Colored Rain palette is the same size as these, but I actually bought the Zodiac palettes, and I also have Capricorn. I use a Capricorn and Pisces so far, and they're actually really good quality, so I was really impressed. This green palette doesn't like give me anything revolutionary that I can't create from my current collection, but I was still impressed with the quality. I haven't used this one yet. So let me know, you know, what type of videos you'd like to see. I know they're not like the newest palettes, but I just love BH so much. So I did actually end up putting this in my cart when I bought the It's My Rare palette. So yeah, excited to try that out when it comes in. I feel like I'm gonna somehow end up with all of them, which was never my intention to begin with. Okay, so the Dose of Colors x Minnie Mouse collab, did not see that one coming at all. I bought the Mickey Mouse one because they did restock it a few times the last couple of weeks. Dose of Colors did. That was so sneaky of them. They should have told me they were going to do a Minnie Mouse collab as well. And the completionist in me was like, okay, buy the other one too, buy the other one too. But I managed to like restrain myself and say no. So yeah, I didn't get it, but I did think it was a cute collection. I can totally see somebody that's a huge Minnie Mouse fan just going for that. And I think the colors are really beautiful. It's nothing new for me, but I think it's a cool idea. I am kind of eyeing this Pat McGrath Eye Ecstasy eyeshadow kit thing that I told you guys about when we were talking about the singles. I might get it during the VIB sale potentially. It's just that the shades aren't that unique to my collection, so I've been holding off, especially since I got the Capricorn palette by BH Cosmetics, and that's beautiful. And I also got the ColourPop Brown Sugar palette, which is also a really beautiful neutral palette. So really don't need any of this stuff, but you know how it is. It's like an itch you can't scratch, so kind of excited about that. Trend Mood posted on her Instagram that Sephora is potentially doing a credit card, and so I've seen a lot of people talking about this. I don't really know how this is gonna work. Sephora has a pretty shitty system as far as their points and stuff like that, so it'd be nice to see if the card like improves that. I mean, they're nowhere near like Ulta's like point system. But yeah, I don't really have any thoughts. I feel like, you know, everyone's an adult, and you know, if you want to get it, you should get it, like whatever. Okay, this was exciting and I kind of want this, but I know I don't need it. Natasha Denona launched the Biba palette, and this is a basically all neutral type palette for $129. So this is one of our big palettes, and I don't know, something about it just looks so beautiful and I kind of want to get it, but I really don't need it. So I said no so far, but oh my gosh, the shade Prairie, it's just like calling to me. It's calling to me. Okay, so MAC did also reveal the Aladdin collab that they're doing, and it's gorgeous. I kind of just want like the bronzer so I can rub it all over my face. But also, like, I'm not the biggest Aladdin fan, so it's not really like the end of the world. And also, I'm not the biggest MAC fan, so I really am like annoyed with myself that I'm kind of like attracted to it, but it's totally the packaging. And I'm like so old now that I'm not about to like stay up till like 2 a.m. trying to like refresh the MAC site to buy their Aladdin collab. So yeah, I think I'm gonna pass on it, but I think it is really beautiful, and it actually looks like they kind of tried a little bit to make it cohesive with the brand. I wish they had done a color that was like Jasmine's clothing. Like, they should have done like a periwinkle color, or like whatever that teal blue shade is. It would have been really nice if they could have done a shade like that in the palette, but you know, I don't work for MAC, so. Okay, Jouer is coming out with a new powder. It's called the Soft Focus Hydrate and Set Powder, packed with hyaluronic acid and vitamin E. This is $30 and they're coming out with 6 shades. I actually love a good setting powder, so I think this is a fabulous idea, especially if it works well. I won't be like running out to buy this, but I'm sure hopefully it'll come to Sephora at some point and then I might eye it. But yeah, I think it's a cool idea. Okay, so the other thing I'm really excited about is this Glam Light palette. They did show a burger palette, and I believe I talked about it in my last Will I Buy It video, but then they showed the taco palette and I was like, screw the pizza, screw the burgers, I'm here for the tacos. The picture on the like the marketing campaign, the picture looks so good, like I literally want to eat the freaking palette. I don't, like, if they screw this up, I'm gonna be really freaking disappointed, because I really want like that avocado green shade to be like all over this palette. So I'm excited for that. I don't think this comes out till, oh yeah, it comes out on Cinco de Mayo. So I got a little bit of a wait for it, but that's okay. I still think it's gorgeous. Very excited to see how that turns out. Okay, Juvia's Place did a little sneak peek of the Warrior 3. I'm so excited. Really, really hoping it's something like, you know, mind-blowingly good, and yeah, hopefully we'll get to see it soon. I'm surprised they haven't launched it yet because it was announced quite a while ago, I'm ready for it. Also, Sephora is doing a collection with Marvel. This isn't out yet, but they did show like the mock-ups of the product, and I think from a lot of Will I Buy It videos that I saw, a lot of, you know, the influencers I saw talking about it are pretty freaking disappointed with the whole situation. I personally am not a huge Marvel fan, but the little bit of the Marvel fan in me is also kind of just like, ugh. So definitely not buying that, and I'm okay with that.
Okay guys, I did tell you this was gonna be the longest Will I Buy It video ever because I wanted to be thorough, okay, for once. I wanted to cover everything that I had seen. So for indie makeup brands, I don't follow all of them. Unfortunately, like I just don't have the time. but if you are interested in like a trend mood for indie brands, I think there's like Indie Mood, and then Amy Loves Makeup does Indie Makeup Spotlight, and she does a really good job too. So I'll try and remember to link her Instagram page down below so you guys can support her because she's really amazing. So Sydney Grace, you guys know I love Sydney Grace. They're launching 10 new shades on April 8th at 9 a.m. Pacific Standard Time. And then, so there's just like some beautiful shades. They've been doing sneak peeks. I'm excited to see the whole lineup. I don't know if I'm gonna like right away jump and buy these because I have so many single shadows that I still need to play with. So it might not happen right away for me, but I just thought I'd let you guys know because a lot of you guys asked me about Sydney Grace and I love her shadows and she's an indie brand. So definitely go ahead and support her. Black Moon Cosmetics is coming out with another palette. It's called a Black Metal palette. And they're totally taking their time and like teasing it like one by one. So they've shown quite a few of the shades and it looks very beautiful. And it looks like it's launching soonish. I have no idea to be honest, but it looks like a beautiful palette. Definitely not something I will be buying, but I believe they are sold at Ulta. So maybe we'll see them at Ulta, who knows, it'll be interesting. Davina is doing some multi-chrome shadows. Those drop on April 7th at 9 a.m. Pacific Standard Time. I believe a few of my YouTuber friends have already received this collection because they're on Davina's PR list. And so if you want to see swatches, try and check some of them out. I'll try and remember to link information down below. Don't sue me if I forget. But these look really cool. I personally prefer more like multi-chromes with like a punch to it, and like the green purples are my jam. So this particular collection isn't calling to me, but I like to tell you guys about this stuff in case, you know, you're interested in picking something up from them. Okay, so Cleonaud is coming out with a new collection. I'm so excited, you guys. They're doing a huge multi-chrome collection and they're calling it their stained glass collection. I'm really interested in the ones they're calling jewel multi-chromes because again, like I said, I'm really into like the purples and the greens, and like they have all these really cool previews on their page. So I'm just waiting for them to announce all the good stuff. And then they also came out with this really cute, they're coming out with this really cute makeup bag, which I'm also excited for. And it looks like they also might be doing some cute accessory type brushes and stuff like that. So very, very excited to see what all comes from that. Blush Drive is taking pre-orders on a new palette. Well, it's not new, but it's like a revamped palette and it's called their Neon Dreams palette. I'm slightly tempted again to pick this up, but again, this brand also ships from the UK. And so as tempted as I am, I just can't bring myself to pay for the shipping and wait like maybe a couple of weeks to get it. And it's just like too much anxiety. And then the cheapest shipping doesn't come with tracking. So if they lose your package, I don't know what's gonna happen. So I'm like, I'm good. So yeah, I haven't bought it even though it's really beautiful. Give Me Glow has been like low-key killing it and I'm like itching to buy some of their single shadows, but again, I've been trying to not buy as much makeup and still buying makeup, so it's really horrible, but I like told myself to try and just like stick to palettes and don't buy singles because I have so many singles and I don't get any use out of them for the most part. So Give Me Glow is launching beautiful shades. This shade, freaking Wink, oh my gosh, I want it so bad. Sky High, St. Patty's, Low Battery, oh my god. that red shade. So they're so beautiful and I'm so interested, but I'm trying so hard not to. And then they are also doing little duos and quads. And they've gotten this really beautiful holo type packaging. So I'm really interested to see when all of that will launch, but they're really doing some things at Gimme Glow. So I love their formula. If you haven't checked them out, definitely do so. Okay, the other indie brand I wanted to give a shout out to was Menagerie Cosmetics, because they came out with really, really beautiful singles. Oh my goodness. This lady, again, is a one-man show from what I can tell. And she is making all of these gorgeous shadows. They also have like a beautiful cause behind them. She's trying to like give back to animals, and like 10% of their profits go to like a goodwill towards animals type cause. So super, super beautiful. Definitely, you know, support if you can. These shades just, oh my God, they're so gorgeous. I haven't bought any of these yet. I don't know if I will, because I bought two of their palettes and I don't love the formula. Just because I don't love it doesn't mean you won't. So I just like to talk about them because, again, it's a good cause. So if you feel like supporting, definitely do that. Okay, and then the very last thing I wanted to let you guys know, I was so lucky to receive some PR. This is actually the first thing I've ever gotten in PR, and they sent me some highlights as well as some liquid lipsticks and some eye pigments. But this is from a small indie brand called Amy Loves Beauty. I'm so sorry because I couldn't film on this palette because I got sick and I just couldn't talk, but I still plan on filming a look with this palette. It's so beautiful, you guys. This is the Galactic Phenom palette, and mine's kind of messy, but it still works really well. This shade here called Milky Way just like blew me away, and I also love this shade called ET. These shimmers like swatch so, so beautifully. So if you guys want to support a very small indie brand, it's kind of a nice story actually how they found me. Amy Loves Makeup here on YouTube. She is an affiliate with them, I believe. And then I believe the owner of Amy Hearts Beauty, her name is Dominique, I believe, and she had been looking for people of color to swatch her product, which I thought was amazing. She's actually African-American and Indian, if I remember from our conversation. And she's like, you know what, I felt so bad because I'm a person of color and I feel like I need more people of color swatches of my product. And I thought that was amazing for a brand that just hit 2,000 followers on Instagram to be so conscious when there's brands that have millions of followers and don't seem to care. So I thought that was amazing, and I was so happy that she, you know, gifted me this product. I have talked about this multiple times. I buy all my makeup, nobody sends me anything, so I just feel so honored, and I just want to say a special thank you to them. So if you guys want to do a solid and support an indie brand, because I know a lot of you love makeup so much, check them out. I'll try and remember again to link them down below. And if you use, I do have a code, I don't like earn anything from it, it's just a discount code for 10% off. It's just KH Makeup, my first ever code, you guys. Oh my gosh, am I YouTube famous yet? Can somebody pinch me? But yeah, no, just check them out. I will have a video. I'll do a look. I'll swatch the whole palette for you. And yeah, I just love this palette so much, and it means so much to me that I was able to try it out before everyone else. And I'm so mad at myself because I got sick and I didn't want to come on here and do a video like half-assed. So yeah, I hope you guys will check them out, and don't forget to subscribe to my channel so you can watch more videos from me. I hope you enjoyed this Will I Buy It video. Thank you guys so much for watching. I know that this is gonna be so painful for me to edit because I feel like it's gonna be like an hour long, but I love long videos, so that's all that matters. And I hope you guys have a great rest of your day. Bye guys.